I don't know how many were left. And they just were, it was like a little, you know, like a match being lit.
This is the only way Ronnie Jacobson can see her 94-year-old mother through FaceTime.
Phyllis tested positive for COVID-19 on Monday at Maimonides Geriatric Center in Montreal and was transferred to Hôtel Dieu Hospital Tuesday for treatment.
Ronnie says this is the first time since the beginning of the pandemic that she feels included in the decisions doctors are making to help save her mother.
And I said to them, I said, you know, she won't do this. She needs to be fed. She won't know where she is. She doesn't, you know, she's going to be very disoriented. And they said, would you like us to FaceTime tomorrow? And I said, oh, that would be wonderful. They said, what time? I said, you pick the time. I said, I'm going to be here. I'm not leaving. And I thought, wow, we haven't had that in so long.
Maimonides has 52 positive cases and 11 deaths so far, according to advocates, seeing outbreaks among residents, staff, and caregivers. Ronnie's mother has Alzheimer's and has lived at Maimonides for the last 5 years. The family hired a full-time caregiver for Phyllis to help Ronnie care for her at the residence. She lives in a double room on the sixth floor. Phyllis's roommate tested positive for COVID-19 2 weeks ago, and it wasn't until this week that Phyllis's caregiver was no longer allowed inside as the entire floor was deemed too dangerous.
Flora would tell me, this one left, this one left, this one left, this she saw. Plus she speaks their language, you know, and she would talk to them. Oh no, COVID, we knew COVID. Oh, we knew every day when somebody left. We know everybody on that floor.
Since March, seniors living in long-term care homes who develop severe illnesses due to COVID-19 have been transferred to hospitals. And over the weekend, Maimonides began that transfer too. Patients' rights advocate Paul Brunet says that's not always the best option.
So we have to manage the risk between transferring the patient for acute care or risking that that person will eventually die from COVID. So, but not all patients afflicted with COVID should be transferred because they have COVID. Why? Because they constitute a risk themselves to contaminate other people.
City News reached out to Maimonides but did not hear back. Last Thursday, the home said they'd be sending families a letter after they held protests saying all registered caregivers must provide proof of negative COVID-19 test results within the previous 2 weeks to enter. The Maimonides Family Advocacy Group still demanding mandatory testing among staff and calling for the government to send in the Red Cross or SWAT team to help.
Again, I'm not saying anything bad about Maimonides, but my mother would not survive without a caregiver.
In Montreal, Melina Jubilaro, City News.